Man, you know, I mean, I'm in church to be going at it, man, but, you know, that's my wife, man, and, you know, I spent $60, $70 on your bike, but you ain't gonna put your balls on my wife's neck and then act like everything is okay. That just ain't cool, man. You just can't do that. That dude
feel.
Should put a foot in his ass, man. I don't care about all that bullshit. Dude's soft, man.
But he pound for pound world champion.
Well, he had a pound for pound in his motherfucking ass. So there ain't no way in hell you're gonna put your balls on my wife's neck, man. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
that don't happen over here, man. You know what I'm saying? That's just some soft dude. He knew he could do that to dude, man. You just can't do that to anybody. Man, that's somebody's wife, man.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Gun, no gun, knife, no knife, man. You know what I'm saying? Something's gotta give. That's disrespectful on everybody's end.
Yeah.
Try that with my wife. Try that with Tracy. I mean, the dude bumping into my wife at the club, he got problems. You know what I'm saying? You got problems, man. You just can't come bumping up into my wife up in the club like that, talking about it's an accident. I don't play that shit. Man, and this dude all up there doing this with my wife, I'd have came out the ring and knocked that motherfucking head off, man. He ain't even get mad about this shit, man. Talking about some money. Man, fuck that. That's my wife, man, you know what I'm saying? He make dudes like a punk in front of his own city.
Well, all yeah. A lot of people said that, though. A lot of people said, like, man, the crowd was going crazy. But I'm going to let you go, because I'm going to go ahead and switch it over to my other guy over here, 78 Fight News. Video we was doing, everybody was putting their words out on Floyd and K9's wife and what would happen, because most people didn't see it until it hit the internet, because Showtime didn't show it. And so, but from what you heard of it, what did you think of it?
Oh, man, I thought, man, that it was disrespectful to me, because for Floyd to do that, because it's not a good look for Floyd, first of all, because Floyd, just like Chris Brown, you can't afford to be getting no kind of confrontation. You can't have no kind of disagreement with no woman over in public. You just can't do it. And I felt like he should have, but listen, see, that's where the ego thing come in at, because Floyd, he an alpha male, so he feel like every woman in the room is his. That's how you think. I know niggas like that. Every woman in the room, it was a dude, I ain't gonna say his name on phone, but it was a dude out here who was like a gang leader, once the History Channel, or I think that's the History Channel, which channel did that Gangland special?
Yeah, AMC, I think, one of them.
Yeah, but whenever, when they did that little gangland special on this nigga, this dude started running around acting all stupid and shit, and everything, he wanna, he'd be in a room, and every cat's be in there just thinking, like, we used to watch the fight, and cats bought their girlfriends or whatever, and Trump is a grown man and shit. This nigga, every girl in the room is his, you know. He talking to people wives and shit, and coming over, taking pictures, hugging them, trying to let every woman in the room know that, hey, you see what I'm saying, man? Hey, you know I'm getting money. Yeah, you know all these niggas. I can't fuck with people like that. But I think Floyd shouldn't have done that, man. I think it was disrespectful. And I don't know. K-9 talking about he didn't see it and all this shit. Man, I don't know, man. I don't know if he didn't see that shit or not, but with me, I would have got arrested that night. Because he would have known, like, look, dog, you finna fucking respect me as a man, respect my family. Like, this, you know, I ain't Ice-T. I ain't running around here claiming to be no pimp. You know, that's different. You can try to talk to my girl if I'm talking about I'm a pimp. But this is my wife. You know what I'm saying? You ain't finna be over here flirting with her and put your hands on her, period. I don't care if you're playing. You know, put your hands on another man's wife. You know what I'm saying? He had a fit with 50 Cent, was just taking a picture with the damn girl. With Miss Jackson, he come over there pulling her away. Nah, I'm the man, yeah. So, I looked at it like Floyd should have did that. You know, I know he probably took it as it wasn't a big deal, but I don't think he should have did that, man. That ain't a good look, man. Because that could have got serious, especially in Detroit, man.
Yeah, because I was there live. So I saw the whole thing, man. I was like, oh, wow. The whole crowd was freaking out, man. Plus, you in the Mason Temple. All these Muslims around, they don't play that. So they was there. It was heated. The crowd was more heated because he never saw this. He never knew what was going on. The crowd was heated. They was the ones sitting over there going like, man, that's bulls. That boy, how you going to do that? So the crowd was heated. So I'm like, man, this crowd is heated, man. They watching and he just going on and on. But it was like she pushed him off, you know, because he was dancing and she pushed him. I don't think they got that video or that picture out, but she shoved him, like, off of her and stuff, and she moved. And, you know, he was just, like, talking crap to her, because I asked him afterwards. I said, like, man, like what did you say to him? Because he was bragging about it. He was like, man, I was telling her, I was like, yo, man, K-9, why are you fighting like a chihuahua? He's like, because she had all that mouth early. He's like, she had all that lip earlier, so I was like, so why you ain't talking now, baby? You need to roll with the money team. You know, to him, it was all fun and games, you know, but, you know, like, basically, to everybody else, if you just see the pictures, it looked like he's pulling this dude's wife, you know. I mean, plan or no plan, you know, you shouldn't be allowed to be that close or do what you did at that event. Cause
that's what I'm saying.
He's a promoter.
It's different if that's your friend and y'all get together every weekend and play cards and shit like that. And he claims your wife like that. That's different. But when y'all rivals in the business of boxing and you come over and you ain't got no business arguing with this man's wife, man. Just come on, man. There's other shit to do. You couldn't be talking shit from your side of the place. You gotta go over there. You can tell she's uncomfortable, and she's trying to put, you know, that didn't look right for Floyd, man. To me, it looked like he was trying to knock his woman.
Yeah, I mean, that's the way it looked, but in actuality, I mean, you know, he. I don't think that was his move, but, you know, he was just trying to do what Floyd do. He was just having fun. To him, that's a having fun moment. You know, he's just playing and running around, yelling in the ring. But see, he's a promoter at this point. So, but since Showtime was in control of the whole event, and they just got Floyd, they just said, you know, this your show, this everything, we here for Floyd, because they so happy they got him. It's like, man, you do what you want to do. You know, it's your night. And I'm like, okay, it's going to be my night, too, because I'm rolling right here with him. So that's why I wanted to ask you, because you married. See, married men look at it entirely different than what single dudes looking at. So all the single dudes are saying, man, she wanted it. I'm like, she wanted it. What are you talking about? Look how she's smiling. She wanted it.
Yeah, this guy told me she wanted it and all that stuff. She, man, she did look uncomfortable, man. And that's why he should have did that, man. He should have looked okay. He could have started some problems in the relationship. I could have went home and whooped that woman or something.
Right, and that's why she just said what she said, and then she said, you know, she don't want no attention from me. You know, it's just that the Detroit press and everybody else kind of brought it back up. Because it was dead, it happened, then nobody really see it. Like, nationwide, if you were just watching it on TV, you didn't see it. So when the Detroit press came out and they did an interview, then they brought the pictures out, and then everybody got to see it. Because I talked about it, but I didn't have any pictures. So when I talked about it, nobody really knew. I was like, well, you know, this is going on the side. So when the pictures came out, then everybody could see visuals to what was going on. So now everybody could just go and make story, you know, like make like what happened. Like they make their own story to the pictures. So if you look at the stories, he was like, oh man, that's bogus. He going that dude wife. So, but it's just you're right. It's a bad look. And I knew it was bad when it was happening because I'm in the crowd. I hear them, man. They didn't care he had security or not. And that's what I was trying to tell this one guy. I'm like, dude, he's from Detroit. They're in Detroit. There's a difference. Floyd is from Michigan. He's from Grand Rapids. That's like being in the suburbs. You know, it's not like like you in Milwaukee, you from Racine, it's different.
Right.
It ain't the same thing. And I'm like, they go ride for they guy from Detroit. So that's and I'm like, I'm in the crew, you know, I pay attention to everything. I'm out of town. I'm like, I'm out of town, so I'm paying attention to anything that moves.
Yeah.